Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. So far, we have introduced functions which process a single input variable to produce an output value. In this lecture, we will introduce multivariable functions whose output depends upon multiple input variables. We saw that with real-valued functions of a real variable, x is typically used as the input variable, also called the independent variable. If we call the function f, the function's output value is symbolized by the notation f of x. When the independent variable is x, the output value is usually assigned to the variable y, called the dependent variable. The set of all possible values which can be assigned to the input variable is called the domain of the function, and the set of output values which the function produces is called the range of the function. For functions whose input and output values can be any real number, the domain and range will both be equal to the set of real numbers, R. We can think of a function as mapping elements of its domain to elements of its range. All functions have one domain and one range. In the Cartesian plane, the domain R corresponds to the one-dimensional space represented by the x-axis. Each possible value of the input variable x corresponds to a specific position on this axis. Likewise, a range of R corresponds to the one-dimensional space represented by the y-axis. And each possible value of the output variable y corresponds to some position on this axis. Together, these two positions locate a point in the Cartesian plane, and the collection of all the points in the function's graph is a curve in this two-dimensional space. The curve visually shows how values of the domain are mapped to values of the range. But functions can also be constructed whose output depends upon multiple input variables. In functions of two real variables, x and y are typically chosen as the independent variables, and the output value for a function f is written as f of x and y. This value is typically assigned to z, the dependent variable. For functions of a single real variable, the domain is typically R. But what would be the domain for a function of two real variables? The values of both variables together determine the function's output value. But by definition, functions can only map single elements to single elements. If a function has two input variables, somehow these variables must be combined into a single domain element, which the function can then map to a range element. This combining of variables is accomplished by forming the Cartesian product of the two sets of input values. Forming the Cartesian product of these sets gives us a set R2. R2 contains ordered pairs, whose coordinates are every possible pair of two real numbers. Each ordered pair is a single input element, which the function can then map to a single output value. So the domain of a function of two real variables is typically R2. And for a function which can produce any real value, the range is R. The domain R2 corresponds to the two-dimensional space represented by the xy plane, and each domain element corresponds to a specific position on this plane. The range R corresponds to the one-dimensional space represented by the z-axis, and each possible value of the output variable z corresponds to some position on this axis. Together, these two positions locate a point in three-dimensional Cartesian space. And the collection of all the points in a function's graph forms a surface in this space. Just as in two dimensions, this graph visually shows how values of the domain are mapped to values of the range. Thank you. Since the domain is two-dimensional, and the range is one-dimensional, this function maps points on a plane to points on a line. So multivariable functions, like single-variable functions, have one domain and one range. For functions of two real variables, the domain is typically R2. And if the function can produce any real value, its range is R. Multivariable functions need not be limited to two input variables. Functions of three variables are often encountered in physics and engineering. For example, the air temperature at every point in a room could be represented by a function of three variables. The three independent variables x, y, and z could locate a spatial position in the room, and the value of the function could represent the air temperature at that position. Although it would be difficult to visualize this function using a graph, we can imagine every position in the room containing a number which represents the temperature at that point in space. Functions can have any number of input variables, but we will start by examining real-valued functions of a single real variable. In the next lecture, we will introduce linear functions, whose graphs appear as lines in the Cartesian plane.